Good day, everyone. Today we'll have a small look in, let's say, 20 minutes or so into how to use real-time data processing and insights. We're only going to present one slide. That's this slide. And we have a nice use case because we're going to use actionable tools to do the streaming. And we are going to use very specifically KPN Things. It's an application that you can download on your mobile phone, either Android or, let's say, iPhone from the store. And you already have, let's say, your own IoT device on your mobile phone. Then we're going to show the KPN IoT Hub to connect to that. We'll show you why we use that afterwards, but it perfectly makes sense. And afterwards, we're going to stream it, let's say, on Oracle Cloud. So the green box, our Oracle Cloud. And more specifically, we're going to look at MQTT, Mosquitto more specifically, on Oracle Cloud. We're going to deploy an instance. We're also going to deploy a Node-RED instance we already did and show you quickly the steps. And then we're going to do things. Basically, we're going to stream it to OCI Streaming, let's say our managed Kafka service. The green arrows we are not going to show you today, but that might be a different session. But the other route from Node-RED is, let's say, we're going to push raw IoT data coming from, let's say, these IoT devices on the left into our Postgres database. And eventually, of course, we're going to visualize things in Oracle Cloud. And these things are very much in real time. So these are the steps that we're going to do. We're going to start with the beginning, so the KPN things on the left. Let me open up this screen here. So if you have an Android or an iPhone, you can both download this app. It's called the, let me scroll up, KPN Things Device Simulator. It works really, really well. It basically turns your iPhone or your mobile phone into an IoT device. You basically go to the website, you register, and you get a screen like these two here. You see battery level, acceleration, X, Y, Z, and your location. You see this button there, start sending data. And you can see from 30 seconds to 10 seconds or even faster. Basically, you download the app, you scan a QR code, and you turn your own mobile phone into an IoT app. And that works beautifully. Besides that, KPN not only has an app, but also actually an IoT hub. That's this page here, KPN IoT. I'm using, of course, the free services. But this works really, really well. And why is that handy? Why, for example, does Oracle Cloud care about these things? Well, imagine you have a truck or you have an IoT device. That's, let's say in KPN is an internet provider, a phone provider, things like that. And Oracle is not, of course. So imagine an IoT device being in the middle of nowhere, with, let's say, without internet coverage and all that. That's where these players comes in, right? Oracle does not have an answer for that. But we can partner with these type of companies to make sure that the IoT device actually has internet coverage and we can actually stream things to, for example, Oracle Cloud. So in the Things Manager, the first step is actually, let's say, to add a new device. And a new device is the app. And you see the mobile phone app here. And basically, you download the app, or let's say on your own thing. You scan the QR code and that's already it. You have installed the app and it's connected to this IoT hub online. So that's already it. That's very much a use case for Dummy, let's say, to make things happen as a practice. But as you can see, a KPN can connect to different devices, let's say, and they work on the same thing, of course. That might be slightly harder, of course, to install, but they work on the same thing. So you have a device, you connect it to this platform. We have our mobile app. And eventually, what you're also going to do, of course, you're going to, let's say, stream it to a destination. So you have an input, that's the app, and the destination is our Mosquitto instance on Oracle Cloud. So just be sure, we have this app here, the application, we have the IoT hub, let's say outside Oracle. And the first thing we're going to do is, let's say we're going to connect it to, let's say, Mosquitto MQTT on Oracle Cloud. This is our, let's say, destination. You can add a new destination here. We chose the MQTT broker. That's the one we chose. We fill in the credentials. So we have a specific host, we have a specific port, username, password, a random a client ID, and let's say the topics that we're actually going to target. That's basically it. There's a little bit more hassle to it in terms of certificates, but we're not going to discuss that today. But basically, you fill in these credentials and you make sure that the certificates are in order on the MQTT site, and then you should be good to go. So basically, what happens then, of course, is we have the KPN thing, KPN thing device. I have it here in my hand. It's real-time streaming right now. It pushes it to the KPN hub, and the hub, again, pushes it to Oracle Cloud. So now we have our data, let's say, as a front door in Oracle Cloud. Next step is the Node-RED. So let's first show you, let's say, the end result. So we're going to tackle the middle part, but let's first show the end result, because eventually, of course, we built a very small demo, but it's more of a demo, of course. But eventually, what we want our results here, let's say in Oracle's cloud. It seems to be refreshing a lot. Let's stop that for now. But this basically is a very, it's a dummy example, but this Oracle's cloud, it's a dashboard. And you can see it, the count 230. And let's say when I refresh now, this should be 232 already. So every 30 seconds now, I can make that also 10 seconds. It is streaming my battery level, my acceleration. When I move the mobile phone, it has different acceleration, X, Y, and Z, and latitude and longitude. Well, I've been sitting quite still, so the latitude and longitude are quite similar. But imagine you have things that are actually moving, then in real time, it will make sure that these things are different. And you can see my battery level going up and down. You see my acceleration going up and down. And this dashboard, I think, refreshes now again. So it's already two more already in the minute that we have been talking. So it's actually happening in the background. It's actually real-time processing. And of course, we can do cool things with this. We can make graphs, visualizations, changes, and all that. But it is an Oracle Cloud, so we can make magic happen. So this is the end result, basically. That's what it looks like all the way, let's say, if you go back to the slide, all the way in the end. But let's go to the middle part. So we are here in the MQTT and the Node-RED. So let's just have a quick look on what we did. So in Oracle Cloud, we spin up two instances, two VM instances, one for the Mosquitto, let's say, the MQTT broker, and one for a Node-RED. Just quickly, the Mosquitto, how to install it. There are many, many different steps, of course. But we listed them here just to make sure, specifically, let's say also for KPN, they have some specific needs. So specifically for KPN, we made these steps here. Basically, we install Mosquitto, we run Mosquitto, we open some ports. Specifically, KPN needs, let's say, the secure port. So you need to open the port. We do some testing here. And very, very specifically for KPN, it needs a certain type of, let's say, certificates. And if you don't do that well, then it won't work because it needs, let's say, not self-signed certificates, but authority-signed certificates. You change the config files from the, let's say, from the in the Mosquitto files, etc. And afterwards, it should be able to actually communicate with one another. So that's on, let's say, on the Mosquitto part. You do some testing, of course. And the second part is, let's say, the Node-RED. And the Node-RED is, let's say, more of a platform. So just to be very sure, this is the Mosquitto part. We installed it. We made sure that's connected to this one here. And Mosquitto basically, as let's say, the front door in Oracle Cloud, we can basically forward, let's say, the messages to Node-RED. And then Node-RED, we can do, let's say, more magic. Let's put it that way. But Mosquitto and Node-RED are very much easy to use and also very scalable. So imagine now we are using a very small use case, but imagine this use case becomes very big and small. Let's say that scales up and now very, very fast. That's where Node-RED and MQTT Mosquitto, let's say, play a big role to make sure that there are no issues in that sense. But for now, we're using quite the basic versions of that. In Node-RED, what we actually do, let's say in Node-RED, this is, we installed Node-RED here on this Linux here specifically. And it looks something like this. So in Node-RED, this is Node-RED, we made the flow. This is the MQTT source again. So this the that's very specifically, that's this instance here, the Mosquitto CentOS. That's the source, so it comes in, and then we're going to do two things, basically. You see, let's say, this part here, and you see basically this part here. The debugger you can ignore for now. But this part, basically, we convert, let's say, the matches coming in slightly to a JSON object. And when we do that, we can actually forward it to OCI Streaming. Let's put it, it's a bit more than forwarding, but we, let's say, make sure that the matches get actually into OCI Streaming, let's say, our managed Kafka service. You see now it's idle, but every 30 seconds or so, it will actually, you see now it's turned into sending, it sends a message. So every 30 seconds or so, let's say this all triggers when there's a new message and it sends it. Not going to discuss streaming too much today, but we made a very small stream here in Oracle Cloud. It's called KPN Stream. So the Node-RED will actually forward the message here. So when I click now load messages, let's say in the last minute, you can actually see that 90 August, that's literally right now, we are pushing these messages. That might look a little bit ugly, this message here, but let's have a close look. You can see offset, partitions, we're using quite the basic things, but you can, of course, change all of this. Might be a new message already. Yeah, there's already a new message, let's say 850. So this is actually in real time happening. So we're pushing forward the load messages. What we're not going to do today, of course, you can use OCI Streaming, and then, for example, data flow with Spark to do a lot of cool things, data processing, real time, and all of that. We're not going to do that today, but that's, of course, very much possible. We stop at OCI Streaming, but afterwards, of course, we can do a lot of things. We can also make sure that different consumers have different topics. Imagine you have IoT devices and specific consumer groups should, let's see, get the raw data, or there's, well, they subscribe to different topics and all that. We can make that work. We stop there for OCI streaming. So now we're going to the bottom side of things. And we're going to push the raw data to a database, which is a PostgreSQL database, and then visualize it in Oracle's cloud. So let's go back to Node-RED. This is the bottom part, the streaming part, and this is the top part, let's say, the Postgres. In the end, you see, let's say, connection, and you see it says connected. Basically, this is connection to a database, Postgres database on Oracle Cloud. And basically, what we need is we need a host, we need a port, we need, of course, the database name, the admin, some certificates that we can just download. But basically, we're connecting here to OCI PostgreSQL, and that's a managed service. So that looks something like this. So in Oracle Cloud, of course, we have the, let's go all the way there. We have database section, and we have the PostgreSQL section. And in there, we have database systems. I spun up a very small one, the smallest shape possible, I think, two OCPUs. That's this one here. This is a Postgres database, specifically for Node-RED. Right now, it has nothing to do with Node-RED, but this is the database that we actually are connected to. It has only one node, but you can add multiple nodes. It only has one primary node now, but we can also add read nodes and all that. You see the certificate here? That's what we use actually to make sure that we can connect to it. And maybe just quickly important, this Postgres database is in the same VCN. It's in a private subnet, of course, but it's in the same VCN as these instances here. And so this Node-RED Linux here is in the same VCN in the public subnet, but that way we can make sure that they very much can connect to one another. Just to be sure, that's this one here. So on the same VCN, the Node-RED Linux, I can actually connect with Postgres. And if I, for example, do this select star from the KPN things table here, while we're actually pushing real-time data to, we can see, let's say, these tables. I had a battery, acceleration, latitude, longitude. Again, I've not really moved them out a lot. But this is basically what Node-RED is pushing the data to in real time. More specifically, this function here basically has, let's say, it fetches here the information from the payload. So it fetches the information that's coming from, let's say, the KPN advice, KPN thing, so like battery acceleration, latitude, longitude. I'm fetching that, and then I'm inserting that into this specific table, KPN things lat long. That's my table that we are inserting it into. So basically, for each error message that we get, we fetch some data and we insert it here, and we push that to the Postgres database. That's basically it. And just be sure you see it sending again, so it's sending data again. An object looks something like this. So, for example, we can fetch more data than we have. We just took several things, but we see, for example, there's a battery. So it's a current battery level. We see the acceleration x to a certain value. We see that for the same latitude, longitude. Well, we can fetch a bit more information. We didn't fetch all of it. Yeah, so we're pushing the data now to Postgres database in real time. That's this Node-RED here. And of course, the end of it is actually in Oracle Linux Cloud. And I think we have showed you all of it. Quickly check. So basically, when we now go back here and you see, let me stop this here and refresh again. You see 264. It might go up now, 2666. So we're actually pushing this Oracle Linux Cloud is actually connected, let's say, to a Postgres database, and we have this KPN thing database. If we quickly see how we did that, we can just make a connection. We click on Postgres. Where are you? There you are. We fill in the credentials, and we make sure that in Oracle Cloud, you actually made a private zone. You cannot directly connect to, let's say, to the private IP. You have to set up a private zone in that one, and then you can, let's say, connect to it. So if you look at the, let's say, the connection here specifically, let's click on Inspect. That's the one. Now we can actually see, let's say, the things that we are connected with. So these are the this Oracle Linux Cloud connection to the managed service. So that's the end result. This example here, this data set. So basically, as a small recap, what we did, we have an IoT device. I have it here running on my phone. That's here. We push the data to KPN IoT Hub. That's again has nothing to do with Oracle. But imagine you have tracks like this one here driving around the world, let's say, then we have to make sure that that internet connectivity is ensured. And that's something that Oracle has not a big deal in, of course, and we can help, but that's where partners like KPN, for example, can help with. Afterwards, that platform makes sure that the data comes into Oracle Cloud. We use Mosquitto for that on a VM. We push forward basically to Notepad, and then we can do some magic. How we push it on the left to OCI Streaming, that's where we stop. Let's say our managed Kafka service. But there, usually we do real-time processing. So imagine I want to check the movements, or I want to merge multiple tricks, or I want to do other things. That's all perfectly fine, of course. And the other way, of course, we can always push a lot of data to a database. We did that for the database with PostgreSQL. And we made the connection with Oracle's Cloud, which is refreshed, let's say, every few seconds. And we get the real-time information from my mobile phone into Oracle Cloud and visualize onto the screen. That's it. Thank you for watching.